Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about how to create an effect something like this. So you can see we've got a little ball that's rolling down some steps. It's got some holes in it. There's clearly a light inside it that's changing color. And then we've got these sort of god rays shooting out from the ball as it rolls down the steps. So we're going to cover a little bit of rigid body physics as well as how to set the mist up. This is all done in Eevee in order to make the render time more reasonable. Before I get started, don't forget to click like and subscribe. And also, you'll now see beneath my videos some hashtags. And if you click the first one, which is SardiPax, you'll see a lot of my more popular videos. So to begin with, let's just create some simple steps. There's a multitude of ways to do this. I'm just going to start by adding a cube. We'll make it a little lower and scale it on the Y a little bit there. I'm going to select just this edge here, Control B, and then just add a small bevel to it, partly because it looks better, but also because it will help ball roll down. Before I do that though, I'm just going to apply scale and Control B, and now you can see we get a better bevel on there. So in edit mode, I'm just going to duplicate it, push it up one, just slightly embedded, and bring it back, select everything, and just do it once more. And you can do things like that with arrays and so on, but it just really isn't necessary. I'm just needing a few steps. So that's my steps created. We'll just give them a basic material. I created a sort of wood effect for mine, and we'll apply that under the viewport settings as well. Before we go any further, because I'm starting to do material setups, we'll just go to Eevee, because that'll be a lot quicker to render. I'm going to add a lamp, which will just make a sun lamp, but it's going to be fairly dim. I set mine to a strength of about 0.15, so it's quite a dim light because obviously I want the light from the god rays in the mist to really show. And I set it to quite a narrow angle as well, so shadows were fairly strong. So if we go into Eevee mode, and I'll set the background just to black, and we'll turn off the grid. So we've got a few artifacts there. We can make it a little better with contact shadows, but if we come up to here under Eevee settings, under shadows, we'll say soft shadows, and that improves that. It's just an artifact of the way Eevee works. If I increase this number here, you can see the shadows get even softer, but we'll go with 0.1 for the moment. Okay, so that's my stage. So we'll now add a mesh, which is an icosphere. You can see there it is there. And I'll go up a couple of subdivisions. It's got four subdivisions, this particular one. And we'll move that up now, and we'll go into edit mode. A twice to deselect, and then we'll go up to here and say select random. But before we do that, actually, we'll go to face select and then say select random. So you can see it selected random faces. And then I can play with this ratio down here to reduce the number. I don't want too many. So that looks fine. Obviously, I can just change this random seed to mix it around a little bit. And what I then did was held shift down, occasionally added a few selections and removed a few where there were too many blocks. I didn't want everything joined together, and I didn't want large areas where there was nothing. So that looks pretty fair. We'll just remove some of those, maybe add one there. So then I just pressed X and removed faces. So we've now got some holes. You can leave them like that, or what I then did is just Control 2 to add a subdivision surface, and you get these sort of more curvy holes in it. So we can then position and scale our ball, put it about here, we'll make it a little smaller. It won't go too small. It needs to be a little bit above, and what I also found in order to make best use of the rigid body is it needed to be just over that little piece just there. If its center of gravity, which is the origin point in this case, is over here, it would just bounce a little bit and then settle. Whereas by putting it here, it gives it an initial push in this direction, and then with luck, it will have enough momentum to keep going down the steps without it going too fast. So let's put it up there, and I'll just apply scale. And while I'm at it, I'll apply scale to these again down here just to make sure. I don't think I rescaled anything, but we'll see. We'll place the ball centrally to give it plenty of room to move around. And we'll now sort out the rigid body world just to see that that's going to work. So we'll come down here with the ball selected, and we'll say rigid body. Now, if I just press play, it falls through the floor, so we know it's affected by gravity. I'm going to select my steps and say rigid body for them as well. And obviously, if I just press play, they both fall down. But for the steps, I'm going to change those to passive. So they'll now stay where they are, but any rigid body object colliding with them will be affected by them. And you can see that worked. However, you'll also see it's not really working like steps. It's sort of floating along in the air. And that's because it's created something called a convex hull. So it's sort of created a lozenge shape around it rather than respecting the actual shape. So I'm going to change this to mesh. It means there's more calculations for Blender to do, so it can take a little longer, but it's not too bad. and this is still a relatively simple shape. And now you can see the ball is rolling along as you would expect. And that's just what we want. We can play around with other things such as the weight of this. Because this is a very simple shape, I can leave this as convex hull. If it was a more complex shape, I might need to select mesh, or I could just go for sphere, which will make it perhaps roll a little more smoothly, even though it's got quite a lot of faces anyway. You can see that looks fine. So this, by selecting sphere, it's literally just interpolating a sphere around that encloses this mesh. You can see these dotted orange lines around. And we can play with the mass, obviously. I could put it up to 5 kilos. And you can see it's giving an idea of a much heavier ball there, but obviously carries its momentum. Or we can go for a much lower weight, so we can go for 0.1 of a kilogram. Doesn't fall any less slowly, of course, because that's the nature of gravity. Not much difference in it, so I'll just leave it where it is for the time being. One of the things you might need to look at, depending on how it works, I did need to adjust it for my simulation. Under surface response, I needed to play around with bounciness. Friction I felt was fine. If you take friction off completely, and you may need, you can see it's like it's greased. So it's sliding down without even rotating. So that's not something we want to completely remove. But you notice it doesn't bounce at all. It just hits the surface and then starts rolling. And I felt we ought to have at least some bounce in there. It's not always going to work as well as you'd like. And you do need to look at the same effect on the ball as well. So now you can see we've got a little bounce. Just put even a little bit more. And obviously the weight will have an impact on that as well. We go up to 0.5 of a kilogram. And that's better. So that sort of looks a bit more natural. So let's give the ball a material. We'll make this a metallic material, but relatively rough, not completely rough. I put some surface texture on it, but we'll leave this one as it is for the time being. But obviously what I now need to do is to put a light inside it. So I'll come down here and I'll put a point light in. There's the point light. So if I select my sphere and say Shift S, I can say cursor to selected. Let's put the 3D cursor there. And then I can select my light and say Shift S and say selection to cursor. So that's now put the light precisely in the center of my object with the light selected at the moment. Now holding Shift and selecting my sphere, Control P and say object. And now when I move this around, you can just about see inside the light is moving around with it. So if I open up here, you can see there's my icosphere. We'll call this steps. And within my icosphere, there is our point lamp. So to begin with, I'm going to modify it slightly, but to begin with, I put a power of 10,000 watts, a very bright light indeed. So if we go to the rendered view now, you can see that's extremely bright. Now the radius needs to come down because that's what's causing this weird effect around it. You wouldn't get this with cycles, but you do get some strange effects with EV because it's making shortcuts to get to the effect we want. So I set mine to 0.04. We'll see what that looks like. We need to go smaller than that. So it's just making it a point light, and you can now see it's casting its light onto there. Not sure how it ended up moved there, so we'll just move that back over to where we need it to be. There we go. You can see it's just projecting very, very bright light, but we're going to put volumetrics into the scene, which will cut the light down quite a lot. That's actually looking pretty good. And we can start off with a color for the light. So we'll go with a yellow light. You can see that works pretty well, given this is real-time rendering right now. So next, I'm going to add another cube. We'll call this one mist. We'll go into wireframe and we'll put the cube over our stairs. Doesn't need to be particularly low. It depends really where our camera is going to be. So I'll also position the camera at this point. So right now that's what the camera is going to see. And just to make things easier and quicker in case I make any changes, if I go to the settings here, you'll notice there's an option for rigid body world. If I open that up and open this up, you can see we've got a cache start and end at 250. So if I set this animation to longer than 250, I would need to increase the end frame here as well. Otherwise, it won't create a rigid body world that far. Now, in actual fact, my icosphere is rolling off the end just under 250. So it's fine. So we'll leave that at 250 for my animation. If you find, because you're dropping it from higher or whatever other reason, the ball is tending to go through the object, things like that, you can increase the number of sub-steps here and it will do more calculations and take longer. But the main thing to do is bake all dynamics. And you can see, because it had already baked it, it was there already, and we've got a darker rather than this lighter orange line here. So it's now not having to recalculate anything, it's just in a cache. You will need to have saved your file in order for that to work. Now I can go to my mist. I actually don't need it to be quite that tall, so I'll select the top there and we'll just bring that down something like that. I'm going to open a new window here, go to the shader editor and do a very, very simple material. So we'll just say new here. I'll remove the principal shader. Now I could use a principled volumetric shader, but for this effect, I don't need anything that complex. So I'm just going to add under shaders, a volume scatter node. Important, make sure that plugs into the volume input on the material output, not the surface. And I used a very low density of about 0.005. So let's have a look what that looks like. And you can see it's starting to work. It looks very crude at the moment, and that's because I haven't tweaked the settings for EV yet to improve that. So we'll do that now. We'll come up here and then under volumetrics, I set this to the highest resolution I can, which is 2. And you can see immediately that's looking better. And I set it to samples of 128. And a distribution of 0.9. Be careful with that one, because if you go too high, you'll crash it. Now, I think for the scale of this particular model, I may have gone a little overboard with the lamp, so we can probably turn that down a little bit. But let's try 5 kW. It's also worth turning on screen space reflections. You can see we've got a bit more reflection there. You may want to turn on motion blur. That will slow the animation down a little bit. And bloom. With bloom though, it'll probably be way over top to start with. So I turned mine down to something like 0.3. Again, it will vary. Perhaps even lower for this one. So you just get a little bit of bloom. You may get this effect around the ball. I did as well. It's an artifact of the way that EV renders in volumetrics. If you make a larger model, it may be less of an issue. It's a sort of glow from the lamp that's immediately around the object. But I think it's not too bad. You can see it working there. This is, of course, a preview render. This isn't how the end animation exactly looks. You have to stop it to see a better approximation. I decided to add one little constraint to the camera, which was a damped track. So you put that in and then select the icosphere. You need to select minus Z so that it comes back into view. And now when I press play, you'll see the camera follows. Doesn't actually run, move along with, but keeps pointing at the icosphere, even as it goes down there. So just one last thing, and that's to set the color change effect. So we're at the beginning of the animation. I've got my lamp selected, so I'll just hover over the color and press I. Then we'll come in 15 or 20 frames, and we'll just do the same again without having changed anything. So that holds that color for a short while. Then we'll come in a little bit more and we'll change to a different color. Press I again, hold it for a little bit, press I again, and so on. And we just go through there, changing to different colors as we go, just remembering to hold it for a bit, or you'll just get a mixing from one color to the next. And then at the end there, we'll just return it to white just as it's about to roll off the end. And you can change anything, of course. You could change things like the power of the lamp as well. And we don't need to add a second point because we're not changing it again. So if we have a look at what that looks like. And there we go. So that's all there is to that little animation. You can play around with things like the density of the mist and so on to see if you get more of an effect that you want. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to click like and subscribe. Don't forget about the hashtag below the videos so that you can click that and see lots of other videos that you may find interesting. I will upload this for my Patreon supporters, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.